Thank you very much for attending my class so early in the morning, and happy 4th of July. This is something that you know, Japan may tend to do, but I believe that here it's very relevant. So we're going to start with a few mantras. Of course, Ganesha being the it's a deity to protect us for Jyotish, and Jyotish, Gambhira, and also there is this mantra that I like a lot. It is the Gayatri mantra, which is also used to, as Trayaschita, which is like to calm the mind. So we're going to do that, and Om Chakraye Namaha, to say hello to someone and to protect us during this class.
The mind is a tricky thing. So it's not that, in one day,
by, you know, spending $1 million in a puja, or by doing like, you know, 7,000 sad mantra in a day, that you are going to be able to purify the mind or to have the courage, you know, to face the obstacles. So it's really important to do something a bit every day. As all the teachers were saying, you know, it's the little bit every day that is really important. So we're going to see, according to the planets in your chart, you know, how we are going to be able to propitiate or strengthen the planets. But before we go into that, there is this very important concept that you have what's called the dhrit karma. So it is a fixed karma. Dhrit means a firm or hard. And there is this portion of the karma that is very difficult to change, no matter what you do. And so it is shown in the chart as very difficult planetary placement to affliction, so you know, some difficult houses. And no matter what you do, you cannot really get rid of all the karma that you have been born with. But there is something called also adrit karma. So adrit karma means non-fixed karma. And so it is a karma that can be changed to a certain extent, you know, by doing busy things, by being aware, that kind of thing. And there is also the mixed karma, the adrit karma, which is the karma that can be changed through perseverance and a lot of effort. And so Jyotish offers remedial measures, or what's called upaya, upaye. It is used to alleviate or mitigate our karma. You know, it takes God thousands of years of tapas to get rid of one thing. You know, we nearly live 100 years at the most. You know, how could we just get rid of all our karma, you know? So we cannot get rid of all our karma, but through perseverance and discipline and understanding our natal chart, we can try to change some of the conditions. So remedial measures, what is it? You know, Bill Levacy did a beautiful class on really, you know, trying to understand the world in Sanskrit, because Sanskrit is such a beautiful language, and every word has so many meanings. So, you know, every time I quote the Sanskrit dictionary, it is called the Munier Williams Sanskrit dictionary that I use online and also in the book. A Sanskrit dictionary is a very difficult thing because it uses the Sanskrit order of the alphabet. So you need to understand a bit of Sanskrit, you know, to really look into it. But when you start looking into the words, it's so fascinating. So, you know, upaya is a word that is used for remedial measures in Sanskrit. So it means that by which one reaches one's aim, a means or expedient, way, strategy, craft, artifice. But also, it shows something interesting. A means of success against an enemy. Four are usually enumerated, so in deception, negotiation, bribery, and open assault. So I thought, yes, what does this mean? You know, it's like, I didn't understand. So, Bhagavad Purana is a story of Krishna. And Krishna is said to have given the following strategy for diplomacy. And this is called Chatushtayam, the four diplomatic principles, which are Sama, which is persuasion and conciliation, Dana, offering remuneration, Bheda, causing division, and Danda, punishment. So those are the English words were given by Swami Shivananda in this human ideal. I have given the link here. And by the way, if anyone is interested by this PowerPoint presentation, I'm more than happy to send by email. I will give you my email address at the end. So please email me and I will send you a copy of the PDF. So I was interested by those four principles. And so Camilla, I found out later that Camilla, my teacher herself, wrote about the upaya. So Vedic astrologers resort to upayas, or remedial measures, which are essential to balance the energy. Upaya in Sanskrit means to make a strategy to defeat the enemy. It is usually used to find the answer to a problem. When any problem happens, usually you ask for the upaya for this. What efforts are required to overcome the hurdle? What are the means to defeat the enemy? The hurdles in war are tackled by strategy. So there are four recognized strategies to defeat the enemy. It is Saman, conciliation or diplomacy, Dan, donation, Ped, deception, and Dan, discipline. So these were used to control the enemy. And in Jyotish, Upayas, we also control the inner enemy by diplomacy and conciliation with the planets, donation of our time and energy to heal the wounds, yoga, fasting, and austerities as personal discipline to stop the outflow of energy and dissension of disagreement with the negative forces of the planet. Actively fighting them to quell their uprising and studying deep philosophical texts to counter them forever taking roots again. So I think that we have to take those four actions so that we can understand and then act actively. So this is where Mars comes in. The courage that one, you know, one has to have the to act upon those enemies in our charts. So how are we going to balance the karma that we have been born with, and what are the means that we can use, and how can an astrologer help? Is what we're going to look into now. So Saman is persuasion and conciliation. So Saman means calming, tranquilizing. Kind of gentle words for winning an adversary. So conciliation, negotiation, and friendly means, you know. And so it's a bit of diplomacy and conciliation with the planets. So you have to be nice to them, you know. You have to strengthen what is strong already in your chart. And you have to be nice to them. So there are always external and internal remedies. External remedies being, for example, for Saman, it is about pacifying a deity by worshipping to reduce or increase the bad or good influence of a planet. So you know you do the mantra for a good planet to strengthen it. So you do propitiate a mantra for a weak planet, for example, for the planet to be happier with you. No? And the internal remedy is to practice equanimity, which, as we will say later, it's really a key. To this upaya, and to appease oneself, take everything that comes with peace of mind, because you know when we do have peace of mind, we can counsel the others. But of course, if you do not have the peace of mind, it's very difficult to cope with difficult situations. So peace of mind is something that really comes at first. So. The internal remedies here that I'm giving you, and it's really good food for thought, so I think that it's very good that everyone thinks about, you know, what are those four categories for ourselves. And they were given by Sri Sri Ravi Shankar on his website. I'm not affiliated with him, but I thought that they were really good, so I'm giving you these for food for thought. So the next one is Dan. So, Dan is offering remuneration, but it's an act of giving, communicating, imparting, teaching, paying back, restoring, donation, gift, donation. And donation of our time and energy to heal the wounds. You know? So the external remedy would be like offering or donating money or articles related to a certain planet in order to decrease or increase the bad or good influence of a planet. As we surrender to the energy of the planet. And the internal remedy will be giving up what disturbs us. You know, surrender the mind, which is the cause of our sorrows, problems, and misery, being forgiving. When the mind goes, let it go, follow it, and bring it back. You know, there is this beautiful idea that, you know, we do not need to really, like, control the mind in a way that, you know, we are really forcing it to be calm. You know, the more we are forcing, the more all over the place it will be. So I think that it's very important to understand that, you know, by doing the external remedy, we can also help the internal remedy as well. So Ped. So this was the most difficult one to understand, because after all, you know, we all teach about unity and we all teach about the non-duality, and so why would causing division be some act of remedial measure, you know? So pedha means breaking, splitting, cleaving, everything that is really divisive. But at the end of the definition, I found breaking open, disclosing, divulging, betraying of a secret. So pedha in diplomacy is, you know, for example, when you send a spy to the enemy, and you know, you send the spy, and you know, you have this spy tell, you know, lies to the other, to the enemy, saying, you know, we heard that this group is in fact very good, and you know, so you should join them, or they're actually very bad, so you know, we should plan an attack, but you know, but then you know, they would plan an attack, and of course, the spy would tell her, to tell the other camp, you know, when the action was going to happen, that kind of thing, you know, like that kind of like really like trying to separate. And there is this, we were talking about the kind of Sattva Yoga, Camilla has been telling about the coming transits, and you know, when there is some splitting factor in one side of the chart, there is this hemmed in between the two, Rahu and Ketu. There is this divisive energy in the chart. So I was wondering, why would dissension or disagreement, you know, be have a say on these remedial measures? And so Camilla said, know the secret of the planet. This can be used in a positive way to break the hold. And so we have to understand the secret of the hidden positive side of the planet, because it's not necessarily obvious. We tend to think as Saturn as a fearful planet. You know, he gives us all the obstacles. But in reality, Saturn is just not a bully. He just teaches you to get on the right path. And Saturn is just as great as giving you a reward at the end of a hard work. Saturn is a planet that will give you the reward. You know, Saturn is a natural ruler of the 11th house. You know, the 11th house gives you all the, you know, it's the house of income. But why do you get the income? Because you have been working hard. Have been like, you know, really appeasing Saturn, and then he will give you the rewards. So the external remedy is about you know, to really donating, offering, keeping items related to that particular planet to try to remove its maleficence and prove the positive aspect. But also the internal remedy, which I found really interesting, it is about differentiate, separate the perishable from the perishable, because we are merely this body. And this very body is so hollow and empty. One has to understand one is not this body or sensations. We always react to sensations, to emotions. So these circles of craving and aversion with sensation and emotion made your life, both subtle body and gross body, adapt to you from life to life. So another thing that you can do is to dissociate yourself from the sensation. So this is all, you know, about the mind and how to calm your mind so that you are able to discriminate if what you are feeling is really you, or it is just merely the mind playing tricks, you know. So the internal, so in order to, for this internal remedy will work, is that, you know, I really feel that meditation is really essential to be able to achieve the right discrimination, the proper view, and going beyond the intellect. Because one can be a bit, you know, addicted to one's, you know, what was achieved in academic circles. You know, one can be really like hooked with our intellect. And really, you know, one has to come from this very deep peace of mind that one has already in us. So danda is punishment, and danda means a stick, staff, rope, pole, you know, everything that, and the rope as a symbol of judicial authority and punishment. So the punishment is about danda. So yoga, fasting, austerities, and as personal discipline to stop the outflow of energy is about danda. The external remedy would be throwing, immersing, burying, or burning articles related to a particular planet for altering the negative effects, consciously taking on a difficult task, being disciplined for an effort to be made. So, you know, as an example, fasting on certain days is said to be very good for certain planets. So we'll look into like more detailed examples later. So the eternal remedy, you know, also what Sri Ravishankar gave is that Dandan means support. It's a rod, you know, so it's a support. And dissemination and commitment, your spiritual discipline is Dandan. So mind is like a vine. It needs support. Listening to spiritual discourses, satsanga, practice, guru's presence are all the supports of Dandan. Persevere with sadhana or spiritual practice and regularly renew commitment and intention. So as was the theme of this, you know, we have all the teachers who are really talking about this intention that you set. That, you know, the intention, be careful what you wish for, because you know the intention that you set will take you there. I always give the example that I'm not really good at going on a bicycle. So you know, you go on a bicycle, you look, you know, for people who are familiar with going on a bicycle, they would just look, you know, where they want to go and that will take you there. But you know, I'm so scared that, you know, I look towards a wall that is just next to the road, and inevitably, you know, my bicycle, because I'm looking there, I will, you know, my bicycle will take me there and I will crash and I will get hurt. So, you know, this is the kind of thing that that can happen when you do not set the right intention, you see. So, really, setting the right intention is one of the most important things. So, remedial measures according to the planets. So, there are general remedial measures, such as awareness, internal remedy to transform a negative pattern into a positive one. So, all in all, I think that, you know, as even for people who do not understand Jyotish, I think this is one of the most important things. You know, it's because in order to set the right intention, you have to understand that, you know, what kind of intention is the right one. So being aware, you know, of your child and being aware of what your weaknesses are is probably one of the most important things. So, you know, if we do not set the right intention, you know, you will say later that, you know, for example, donating a black cow is very good for a certain planet. But you know, no matter how many black cows you will donate, if you do not set the right intention, it's like, you know, it doesn't help you at all. So it's like really, you know, saying, okay, I have some weaknesses, you know, I can get angry, I can get very fearful, I can feel guilty, I can feel like, you know, my mind can go all over the place. But it is really the awareness and the intention that you want to go beyond this this state. Because we have been talking about fortitude and transcendence. You know, whatever you have strong already in your child, you have to strengthen it. But whatever is weak in your child, you have to make a positive one, and then you have to transcend it. But you cannot transcend it if you do not understand your weakness.
Yes, exactly that. Exactly that. You don't understand your weakness. You're mistaken about your own mind.
Exactly.
So then you do the wrong thing.
Yeah, yeah, we do the wrong thing. We think that this is well, our weakness, but you know, or we think that this is one's strength. You know, like we're angry, we are like, you know, like my strong ego, and you know, like I can be the leader, no problem. So, you know, this is my strength. So I'm going to strengthen my son. And it's like, we're getting more egotistical, and like, you know. So, what is in your child. So to that extent, you know, it is a mind playing tricks. So you have to really understand that this meditation is essential. And detachment and a dharmic way of life. You know, understand about dharma too. Because as Professor Jayashankar said, you know, dharma is what is in line with the cosmic energy. So you have to understand all that. You have to really meditate on what is the cosmic energy, what does cosmos wants me to do, what is the universal consciousness, what is the non-duality. And so yoga practices to pacify and purify our mind is really, you know, you are in the best place here because you have like this really regular practice of meditation and yoga. And donate money and your time as to study is a very good remedial measure. To study, because you know, the more you study, the more you understand. The more we are given clues to, you know, upon which we can meditate. And so mantra japa is very helpful because, you know, it really Aichyo, cleanse your sheath. Yagya, puja, pilgrimage, visit to the temples is really important. So, as I studied Jyotish in 2003 with Kamina, so she has just started her pilgrimage trips to India and study trips. And so I have been following that most of the years. And so by going to temples, you know, to be honest, at the beginning, we met actually, it's an interesting story, because we met in Belgrade, Serbia, which is not necessarily where you would meet a Jyotish guru. And so I was there at the Western Astrology Conference that a friend of mine was organizing there. And so she said, you know, I have Kamila, my friend who is coming to Belgrade now. Would you like to come at the airport with me so that we can pick her up? And I said, yeah, fine, great, let's go. And I, you know, at that point, Kamila Sutton was like totally unheard of, and I didn't even know if she was there. You know, Kamila Sutton, with her name, I thought that you know, a Caucasian person was going to come and hear Kamila Sutton, you know, gorgeous red overcoat, you know. And you know, that, and she did a 1 hour Jyotish presentation amongst the Western astrologers. And, you know, before that, in Western astrology, I have Moon in Taurus, which is a brilliant, you know, it's a beautiful moon to have. And why would my moon become, get into Aries? It's ethereal. So I used to avoid Jyotish. Oh, that was like, oh, my moon to Taurus. This is a Dutch moon speaking. So I really thought that that was interesting. You know, something I was hooked. So, you know, I asked for a reading and, you know, and the rest is history now. And so I think it's, you know, and she did her pilgrimage, and, you know, at the beginning, so she said, then back in Belgrade, you know, in 1 month I'm going to start my first pilgrimage, my first study trip in India. Would you like to come? Because, you know, afterwards she said, oh, you know, she comes to Belgrade, she can come to India. And, you know, deep down I knew, of course, that, you know, I was going there. But, you know, I was already away from home, going to Belgrade. And was I going to say back home that I was going to India the next month? So it was a bit... So I went there, and it was great. But at the beginning, I had no idea whatsoever what puja was. So here I am in the middle of Kerala, knowing absolutely nothing. And, you know, so you have to come at 4 p.m. because it's puja, and we're going to do the Navagraha puja, which is like, what? So from there, you know, you can really I've come a long way to be sitting here in front of you, but we all have places where we start from, so this is something that I want to share with you. But pilgrimage, visit to the temples is really great, because I really understand now how it can really purify you, and, you know, it can be so uplifting. This January we did this trip to the Rahu temples, you know, to pacify Rahu because of this Jupiter Rahu conjunction that just happened, and it just left. And so, you know, and Tiamat Kamayuga are really the great things to do. And so, the number of mantra repetition, as given in the scriptures, are these. And but, for example, to give you a clue, you know, if you do it 108 times every day, you know, for the sun, for example, it's 7,000 times, and you can do this in 65 days, which is not necessarily something that is like so massive. You know, you don't want to think of this as something that would take like 30 years to do. But, you know, you can like plan ahead and do, you know, whatever is affecting you now or is affecting your child. You can really plan and do those mantras in a few months. Or buy this book. You know? I think that Andrew has been doing great classes, and, you know, you can really, like, you know, like the just the thought that, you know, you can have the pada of the planet, you know, where it is in, and, you know, like to have a personalized planet, planetary mantra is really great. You know, I think that this is a really great book and information to have. So we have to identify the plans that are positive to us and which ones are negative in order to strengthen the positive and propitiate the negative. So this is where it's tricky. You know, you cannot say, because Jupiter is Jupiter, Jupiter can be a malefic or Saturn can be a benefic. So you know, you have to understand that as well. You have to understand, you have to study a bit of Jyotish to understand, you know, what is really strong in your chart. Because what is a weakness on the surface can be a very strong strength inwards. So you know, you have to study a bit of divisional charts to really understand the real strengths or weakness of the planet. So take into account the sign and how the planet is in, the disposition of each planet, to properly evaluate the strengths and the weaknesses of the planet and check the transits. Especially Saturn, Rahu, Ketu transits are important because those are the karmic planets. So when Saturn, Rahu, Ketu transits your personal planet, this is a moment where you will experience some difficulties or some karmic events, but this is the excellent timing for you to work on your karma. So this is really, you know, a timing where you have to be aware that this is where the time that we can pay our karmic debts. So it is not necessarily a time where you can say, oh, it's my boss's fault, or it is my mother's fault, or it is my, you know, whatever. It is the neighbor's fault who is trying to make a fence, and I don't like this, so I want him to get rid of this fence, whatever. So what is the event trying to teach you? You know, what kind of weakness it is highlighting in myself so that we can just move beyond. So this is the most important thing, and the dashar will also show you what is highlighted in your chart now. So if you go, like those many years of Saturn or Rahu Ketu transit, you know that this is an excellent time for you to pay the coming debts. So as we have been saying, you know, for some people, business-wise, Ketu dashar may be very good, of course, you know, depending on the status of your Ketu, but you know, it may be a very spiritual time too, and it may be a very good time for you to pay back your coming debts. So the sun, for the sun, Mahamalika Jayama plays a very good mantra to do, or Surya worship. Yes, in order, you know, there are gemstone therapies. And gemstone is a bit of a tricky one because, you know, it's very difficult which gemstone is good for you. And to that extent, I think that, you know, it's very important to seek the advice of some knowledgeable people. And just before coming here from April to June, James Kelleher did an excellent Jyotish Religion Measures online class. And I took it, of course. You know, I knew that I was going to talk about on this subject, so I took it. And so I have given the link at the end, but I think that Jeff Kelleher did a great job. It's like 9 classes of 2 hours each, and he will really give you the details on how to choose a gemstone for you, and you know what are the mistakes not to make. And so I would really, if you want to look deeper into the subject, I would really recommend you, because he's selling his the recordings of the class on his website. Okay, so the gemstone is ruby set in gold, and the mantra is Om Suryaya Namah. But of course now you know that you have like 108 mantra for each planet. So you feel free to delve into that as well. The color is red. It's more blood red, as opposed to Mars, which is like coral red. And the day of the week is Sunday. And you know, something that was taught to me at the beginning and that I found really helpful is that just be in the sunlight. You know, eat locally made fresh fruit and vegetable, which received a lot of prana from the sun. So you know, even like this kind of like remedial measures is very important if you have a weak sun. You know, it's really important to be in the sun. You know, but people will say, oh, I hate the sun, and I hate to be in the sun because it's like too hot or too... So understand that this is your weakness. Understand this is where, you know, you feel at the beginning that you don't like it because, you know, you don't necessarily want to face the sun, but be brave and you just face it. So in terms of yoga, Surya Namaskar, Surya means the sun, is very good to strengthen your sun. Pranayama to balance the Ida and Pinga, the silent moon nadi. Service of the nation to anything that has to do with father, fatherly figures, famous people, because you know we have to propitiate the sun, so the sun is like about famous people and leaders, people embodying the solar energy. And do selfless service of karma to take the ego and learn about humility, because people with a strong sun can have ego issues as well. So you know you have to tame it, you have to understand that quality too. So the moon. So it is about donating white cow and female buffalo food to charity. Moon is connected with food. Reciting 1008 names of Shiva or Om Namah Shivaya 100 times will really help you to calm your mind. And so the moon rules the mind, so you have to pacify it, you have to purify it. Meditation, pranayama, yoga practice is good. Gemstone is pearl, moonstone. Mantra is Om Chandraya Namaha, the one we have been doing at the beginning. Or the color is white, pearl white. Day of the week is Monday, today. And positive actions wants towards any female cause. Like the moon is a mother, it's female, so it's like, you know, anything like, you know, for single mothers or for you know, people who suffered domestic abuse, that kind of thing would be really good. And Professor Jayashankar said again that prayaschitta, the fire purification of chitta, which is the mind, helps the individual develop the capability to offer, requires a practice of yama and niyama. So you have all learned about yama and niyama, I suppose, and so it's, I will not go there in detail here, but it's like really the, you know, what you have to observe and what you, and you have to be very careful about. So I think that this will really help you in purifying your mind. So Mars, it is about donating a bull, charity, reciting. As you can see, Mahabalitrajaya mantra is really effective to counteract, you know, the negative, because Shiva rules, you know, everything, and so it's, you know, you have to really propitiate Shiva in order to really understand the negative things in ourselves. And pay respect to the Brahmins. Red coral, Om Mangalaya Namaha. It's a coral red color, more, a bit more orangey, and the day of the week is Tuesday. So you know, we can be addicted to anger, because anger is really self-righteous, right? You know, like, I am entitled to be angry because this person did this to me. Why? How dare he? So you have to transcend that into the positive quality of Mars, which we have been talking about in Andrew's class last night. So it's like, you know, like courage, ambition, decisiveness, and having the willpower to overcome this. So move your body, your shape of your excess energy, because you know, if you have a strong Mars, you will have a lot of excess energy. So you don't have to like really constantly move your body, and like you, if you cannot do, as I've been discussing with Brent yesterday, that you know, if you cannot do sit down and meditate, you can just go for a walk. And you know, just going for a walk is rhythmical, you know, walk, and it's like it will put you in a meditative state, and you know. So we have to see what are the strengths and weaknesses. For example, you have difficult planets in the 12th house. It may be difficult at the beginning to be just sitting down, and your mind will go everywhere, and it will bring you more fear and more stress. And so you know, just go out for a walk and just like, you know, and meditate that way. And donate to Mars-related cause. It's like about athletes, about soldiers, about hospice, brahmacharis. So you know, you have to get, yeah, because you know.
Construction.
Construction, yes. Absolutely. Construction of the temple. So this is a very good cause, because Mars rules buildings, construction. Yeah. So memory is about discrimination. And so we have to hone our intuitive skills and cultivate a proper view. This is the most important thing. But we have to, once we cultivate that, we will be able to go beyond the intellect. Beyond, you know, whatever the mind dictates to us, we can say, okay, to the mind, okay, you, I hear you, but it's okay, I know how it is. So Sage Parashara says, pray to Vishnu, because Mercury is connected to Vishnu, reciting 1008 names of Vishnu. or a donation of food and silver articles. Gemstone is emerald or any green stone. Mantra is Om Buddhaye Namaha or any Vishnu mantra such as and color is green, and the day of the week is Wednesday. Jupiter is about Dharma. So we have to really think about what Dharma is, and you know, not to really accept, like, you know, whatever we've been told, but you know, what is Dharma for us, really? You know, to really think about it, and practice it daily, like, you know, really think, you know, is my action dharmic or not? And develop a healthy faith. Because, you know, when we develop a healthy faith, this is where what we're seeing in the world right now, it is about terrorism, it is about, like, you know, this is the unhealthy side of the face of any religion. You know, we can all fall into that trap. So study spiritual knowledge, respect the guru. Gemstone is Yam Sakayo Sitri. Mantra is Om Brihaspataye Namaha, Om Gurave Namaha. The color is yellow, and the day of the week is Thursday. Sage Parashara says praying to the Ishta Devata is important. Ishta Devata is a personal deity, and we can find in the planets placed in the fifth house or the 12th house from the chart at Mangalaga in Navamsha. So this is a bit more advanced, but an astrologer can find it very easy for you, so that you are aware that you have a personal deity in your chart. And so it can be like seen from whatever chart you have. You have 1,008 names of Shiva can be chanted, donating to priests, guru, educational trust, schools, and charity and cows. So the planetary deities that James Kelleher gave online in his online class is this, you know, Rama for Sun, Krishna, Durga for Moon, Kartikeya Subramanyas, Hanuman for Mars, Vishnu for Mercury, Ganesha for Jupiter, Lakshmi. That was interesting. Lakshmi for Venus, Shiva for Saturn, Durga for Rahu, Rudra, Buddha, and Ganesha for Ketu. So Venus, Sage Parashara said that doing puja for Lord Shiva, little Jaya Homa, giving to charity food and white silk cloth is good. But gemstone is about diamond. Mantra is Om Shukraya Namaha. The color is white or pastel, like light colored, like pink, like blue, that kind of color. And the day of the week is Friday. So we have to really meditate on how to enjoy life in a dharmic way. You know, not to be, you know, we have like three levels of Venus. We have the Taurus Venus, which is all about luxury and enjoyment, the sensual pleasures, and to be in a comfortable environment. And the Libra Venus, which is about relationship, you know, like how we can benefit from a relationship and love, and learn about love, and you know, being hurt in the meantime. But also, you know, I can elevate that into the Piscean Venus, exalted Venus. You know, Pisces is also a sign of moksha. So, you know, in order to have like unlimited compassion, unlimited love, unbounded love, is the higher octave of Venus. So how we can enjoy life, but more in a dynamic way, in line with, you know, what Venus can teach us. You know, of course we have to go through some Taurian or some Libra kind of energy, because this is, you know, what it is on this earth. But, you know, we have to really always have in mind this Piscean Venus ideal, so that we can like inch forward to it every day. And to that extent, practicing bhakti yoga is really important, because, you know, you can really tie in this idea of like you know, this link with God that we can have in order to have ourselves unlimited compassion to other people. So Saturn, of course, is the, you know, we are all very fearful of Saturn transit, Sarasvati, you know, whatever. It's like, oh my God, you know, Saturn is coming on to my center, my Venus. So anyway, it's good to fast on Saturday, reciting Mahavitajaya Mantra again, and donating time and money to the poor. And you know, Saturn is a planet of karma. This is why we're really fearful. We really don't want to fix that.
But it's where, you know, I did it the whole day, it's like a workshop, you know, it's this January, and it was like so fascinating to see that, you know, Satan can give such great rewards, as I was saying in the beginning. So it's a great thing to have, a great strong Saturn to have, is a great thing. But at the same time, you know, I know a person who is Saturn exalted in the first house. But you know, there is some tendency to be addicted to feeling miserable, you know. I feel like, oh my God, this is happening to me, oh my God, this is happening to me. And, but it's exalted, but still, you know, there will be this feeling of misery. There is this feeling that, you know, Saturn scrolls, because, you know, Grava is like really seizing. The Grava is a planet that's really, Saturn seizes you. You know, so you have to understand, you know, that Saturn doesn't need to seize you. You know, you can be like, okay, Saturn, you're there, you're in my first house. But, you know, I'm ready to take on your lesson, so, you know, I'm ready to go. And, of course, you know, Saturn Dasha, like, it's not easy, it's like, you know, 19 years, you know, I'm inside 19 years of responsibilities, right? But you can still enjoy it. So there are ways of enjoying it. Just be aware of that, just think about that. And so, gemstone is blue sapphire, but I thought that with caution first, because, you know, one has to be ready to put on blue sapphire. You know, one has to be, like, ready to take on the task of Saturn. So, you know, if you put on, you know, the blue sapphire, and if you feel like, you know, like, really bad, I think it's a good, you know, it's a good thing that, you know, to let it go for a while, and then maybe when you're ready, you can just put it on. Color is dark blue, black, and the day of the week is Saturday. Om Shamaye Namaha. Om Sham Shem Shavaye Namaha. Or consciously take on difficult tasks is a very good remedial measure for Saturn. You know, you're conscious. Therefore, you go to, you know, take on the difficult task as Karma Yoga, for example. It's a great thing to do. Work hard, study intensively, spend Saturdays in a spiritual way. You know, don't, you know, of course Saturday is a party time, so you know, you can just go partying, but you know, just be aware of the energy that Saturday can bring you. Saturn fast is a great thing too. On Saturday for 16 consecutive weeks, it depends on, you know, what is your level. You know, if you are already fasting regularly, if you are already a completely vegetarian or vegan, or, you know, you can just do it from one sunrise to the next one, is great. But, you know, if you ask a lay person to do, you know, a fast, a complete fast, it will not work. You can, there are levels. You can, you know, a person, non-vegetarian person can keep the meals happening by, you know, being vegetarian or by not drinking alcohol on Saturday, maybe, or, you know, so you have to adapt it to break the fast at sunset, for example. One thing, way to do. The normal thing to do is, like, you know, to be fasting with water only, or water and fruits during the day, or from sunrise to sunrise would be a great thing to do. And you have to start it on the first Saturday after the new moon in Cancer, which will happen soon. And so in 2016, it will be from August 6th to November 16th. And you will see it hasn't failed. The moment you place the intention to do this Saturn fast, you will get all sorts of invitations on Saturday. Mm-hmm. It's like, you know, oh, come to our barbecue on Saturday, and, you know, have great meat and that kind of thing. Or, like, you know, great, you know, or whatever. So, you know, you and so it, like, set the intention, and you have to see if you have the weakness to break it and to restart the next year. So it's like, it's something that you have to consider. I have broken it so many times, like, let me tell you that. You know, it's not an easy thing to do. But, you know, you say you want to do a mantra practice for 40 days, and the 39th day, you sometimes forget. So it's like, you know, but it's being resilient, it's being, you know, it's persevering, and it's like...
Can you feed black crows as a medium?
Absolutely, you can feed black dogs, you can feed black crows. It's a great remedial measure to do. Yeah, absolutely. Black dog, yes. Yeah, you can eat black dogs, yes. So Rahu will be about reciting mantras for Durga. The Rahu mantra on Thursday. And it's not, you know, Rahu core rules Aquarius, so we'll be tempted to think about
on Saturday, but James Gallagher gave was a very good reason, because Jupiter really takes this round energy. And so Jupiter is a guru, so you know, doing round mantra on Thursday would be very good. Mantra to Lord Shiva. Gemstone is hazelnut. Once again, there is some caution here, because you know, you put on the Rahu stone and you know you are going to get all sorts of Rahu experiences, so you don't have to be a bit ready for it. Color is blue, Om Rahave Namaha. Let go of desires and attachments. Is easier said than done, but this is the best remedy for Rahu. Ketu, Parashara gives the same remedy for Ketu as Rahu. Praying to Ganesha, doing Ganesha or Ketu mantras. Visiting Ganesha temples is a great thing. Red things, or pray to Ganesha. There are beautiful Ganeshas all around here, so praying to Ganesha is really good. Red things, poor people, sadhu. The gemstone is Tiger's Eye. I should have good caution here as well. You know, you, so you are inviting all your past life energy into this life. You know, when you know, it's strange, because you know, the Ketu, Tiger's Eye is considered as a, you know, as a, for some reason, as a stone for propitiating like wealth. And you know, I see so many people wearing like Ketu, you know, like Tiger's Eye bracelets, and I think, oh my god, do you really want to wear that? Because they're very tricky, you know. But and the color is variegated, Om Ketave Namaha. And use Thursday, as Ketu is also said to be sung in Pisces, and Jupiter rules the sign. So the ultimate goal for us is moksha, but the more we go towards it, the more difficult the challenges will be. So we have to be aware of that as well. You know, transcend rejection by going more than let go of attachment. So it's like, you know, we can be rejected by so many things. You know, we think that we're attached, and Rahu can get to go both ways. We are so attached by something, but you know, we have to experience rejection so that you want to let go of things. So we have to go in order to really understand that there is no duality, that there is no attachment or ego. And I had an example chart here. We're going to very quickly look into this chart. I'm going to tell you who this is after we study it. But what are the good remedial measures for this person? So you know, there are a few things that strike us, you know, to so this person is Sagittarius like now, with Venus, Jupiter in it, which is a great blessing to have, isn't it? You know, two benefits, and Jupiter is in its own sign, and you know, Mars exalted in the second house, it will be like really like strong speech, you know, like intelligent speech. And this is also a money house, so he will achieve some kind of like wealth. But look at this moon. You know, this moon in Scorpio, it is at 29 degrees 47. It is Gambanta. It is debilitating. So what do I have to do? You know, this person will have a very hard time, you know, like pacifying the mind, you see. So every time he will go this route, the easier route, in a way, you know, like he, so it is a lot of blessing. So many things will come easier for him. But when you really understand that, you know, this easier route is no easier route for the moon at all, because you know, it will, the moon is on the threshold of like anything tamasic to anything sattvic, but it is, you know, in the tamasic side still. So it's like it's really thinking, oh my god, I know that there is a sattvic side, but it's easier to go the easier route. So it's like, I don't mind, I'll just. And Rahu is aspecting those two. So it's like, okay, I like having fun, so I'll have fun. So, it is really all about understanding this moon, and all about understanding the difficulty of this moon, and so to try to pacify it, to try to really like take on the, the difficult task of really pacifying this very difficult. But you know, you have to have the awareness first. But of course, when you're younger, you tend to go the Venus, you know, the Venus or Jupiter way that will bring you a lot of affluence, a lot of, you know. and Rahu is about like, you know, in a fifth house. So it will bring you some easy, you know, like flow of things, of stuff coming your way too. So this is a chart of John Belushi. You may, some young people may not know it, but you know, John Belushi is a great comedian, and he's unfortunately he died very young of overdose. And the sad thing, the really sad thing is that, you know, he died just before his own dasha. So, you know, if he managed to live through his own dasha, maybe, you know, something could have been understood, but he lived before understanding this moon dasha. So I think it's a great shame. But you know, he had, like, you know, his speech was brilliant. He was so funny. And you know, Andrew was talking about sunrises. You know, he had a samurai kind of speech that was so funny. But still, you know, it's such a shame that he went the easy way and not necessarily. But his internal struggle that he must have been going through all these years. You know, so you have to have compassion to that kind of person and not judge it by saying, oh, you know, he went through a drug overdose and just that. So, the final note, I would like to, you know, the sadistic intention counts because it will become manifestation. So you have to, like, understand, you know, what is the intention that you're going to set? You know, every new moon you can set an intention. But, you know, what kind of intention it will be? So be careful what you wish for, because you won't get it, you know? So remedial measures cannot just be bought with money. You know, some people will think, oh, okay, you know, some good quality gems can be very expensive. You know, you say, okay, I will buy a 4-carat diamond, and you know, it's very expensive. But if you set the wrong intention, you know, if you have like a wrong type of intention, and then you wear this beautiful gem, it's not good, is it? You know, no matter how rich you are, you're going to achieve a peace of mind? No. So the remedial, and you know, so many pundits unfortunately in India will say, okay, we'll do this yagya for you, we'll do this puja for you, but you know, to just pay for it and to just go and party yourself is not good. So you have to really understand the intention bit, because this will really make or break your remedial measure. And so, and also one has to have faith. The more, what's interesting that the more, you know, for example, you take the vow of doing your Saturn fast. You know, if you do not have faith in the remedial measure that it will work for you, you will become more and more resentful. You know, Saturn is also about resentment. So, you know, and you will start understanding that this kind of, like, you know, why am I doing this? And then you will break it, which is fine, you know. People break vows, you know. I've been breaking so many times. But it is the understanding the intention and understanding that you can do it over and over again so that you can really understand. And then the moment will come when you will be successful in the endeavor. So I would like to end this lecture by doing a Mahamudra Mrityunjaya mantra, which is so good to many planets, and it is the Mahamantra that anyone can recite. Om Triambakam Yajamahe Sukam Yambushti Varanam Uruvarga Minavahanam Vityor Mushyamam Vritam Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Thank you very much for listening.